What is up, my Tickle Me crew? This is Chad here, and welcome back to another episode of my Pokemon Alpha Sapphire Let's Play. In the last episode, we defeated Watson, the Malville City Pokemon Gym Leader, and we got the Dynamo Badge. In this episode, we're gonna head on to the next town, wherever that may be. Also, it's worth mentioning that this is gonna be the first episode in 60 FPS. YouTube just recently made it so that YouTubers can start uploading videos in 60 FPS. The old limit was 30 FPS. So I thought it'd be a nice little treat for you guys if I start uploading in 60 FPS from now on. And I just want to know what you guys think in the comment section below, so please let me know. Alright, so before we do anything, I want to head to the Pokemon Center to heal up everybody. And there's also a town right near Malville City that we need to go explore. I believe it's the town that Wally went to live with his grandparents in. I forgot the name of it. But we're gonna head there first, and then I believe we have to go to Mount Chimney. So we have two destinations for this video, so it should be kind of a long video. And hopefully that'll make up for the last video, because the last video was kind of short. Because I know some of you guys like the short videos, some of you guys like the long videos. Whenever I upload like a really short video, a lot of people tell me, longer episodes! So this is gonna be a longer episode, probably. Alright, so what is this guy? Okay, he's the daycare man. And I actually heard something cool about this game. There's actually two daycares. So you can breed two Pokemon at the same time. Which is pretty neat. No other Pokemon games had that. But I don't really have a use for breeding anything right now. Let's talk to this girl. Alright, so she said that she left her Pokemon in the daycare, and when she got it back, it learned a new move that she never taught it. Okay. So, like, whenever you leave a Pokemon in the daycare and you run around a bit, I believe your Pokemon get, like, one experience for every step you take. So, your Pokemon can actually level up in the daycare, and then they can actually get rid of some of your moves, which is really not good. Because they could randomly get rid of one of your really good moves for a really shitty move, so that kind of sucks. So that's probably what happened to that girl. Alright, so here's a double battle. And they've got a Makuhita and a Zigzagoon, while I've got the Pikachu and Grovyle combination. So, let's see, let's go for the Electro Ball on the Makuhita and the Leaf Blade on Makuhita. I want to get this thing out of the way, it's the biggest threat. Zigzagoon's not really a big deal. Alright, wow, we one-hit the Makuhita, it was a crit. But I'll take it. Alright, so we're gonna go for the Electro Ball on the Zigzagoon, since the Makuhita fainted. And that's gonna take out the Zigzagoon, which is great. HM Slut grew to level 22. Alright, we defeated Anna and Meg. Got some nice money. Also, we should probably switch out... let's see, let's put Gertrude up front. Because she's the only one that's not level 25 other than HM Slut. And at level 25, Gertrude actually evolves, so let's get her to evolve this episode. Here's some berries right here. Got some pineapple berries. So I'm guessing they're pineapples. I actually want to check what they heal real quick. Let's see what pineapple berries do. Alright, so they are in fact pineapples, which is cool. Okay, so it's just for Pokeblocks, and they increase toughness. Alright, so they don't really have any, like, health benefits or anything. They don't get rid of, like, Paralyze or Toxic or anything like that. Just for Pokeblocks. Which, I don't know, we may get into a little bit later. I'm not really big on contests, so I don't really have a need for Pokeblocks. Oh, what was that? Let's check the, Dex Nav. That's weird. I heard some random noise. I don't know if that was like a Pokemon or what. But here's a trainer. Alright, Triathlete Dylan. And he's got a Doduo. Really cool Pokemon. Alright, Gertrude. Let's see, this thing's level 18, so we definitely out-level it. Let's go for Echoed Voice. It's one of my favorite animations right there. I never knew I liked Echoed Voice until now. Alright, it's gonna go for the Fury attack. Does a decent chunk of damage. Another Echoed Voice should take out the Doduo, though. And this is his only Pokemon. Alright, that is a dead Doduo. Awesome! Gertrude grew to level 25, so now we're gonna have a Pelipper! Alright, stop talking. I want my evolved Pokemon now. What? Gertie's evolving. Oh, I love the evolution screen. Are all of our Pokemon evolved now? Not fully evolved, but because I know Grovyle is not fully evolved, but... Oh wait, no, we still have Pikachu. But I don't even know if the cosplay Pikachu can evolve. I'll have to look into that. Alright, Gertrude wants to learn Protect. Nah, it's not really useful in-game. Alright, we have a Pelipper. Let's check out its stats. Pelipper gets a lot more defensive, a lot more bulky when it evolves. Alright, so yeah, its defense is 56, which is nice. We've got a nice bulky Pokemon on our team. Along with Matang here, which has 59 defense, which is pretty cool. So yeah, that's pretty awesome. Alright, let's try out Pelipper in battle. Alright, here's a Pokemon breeder. Usually breeders have like a lot of Pokemon on their team. Alright, yeah, this lady has a team full of 6 Pokemon. So this might be a long battle. Alright, she's got a Wingull. And I've got a Pelipper. So let's just go Echoed Voice. Because she's got a lot of Pokemon, so... After this Wingull, we should like one-hit everything. Because again, if you don't know, Echoed Voice increases in power the more you use it. Plus, I believe we gave Pelipper the Metronome. Which powers up moves that you use in succession. Matang grew to level... Oh my god! Yes! It wants to learn Bullet Punch. I am so learning that. Let's get rid of... Actually, you know what? Bullet Punch isn't even that good, like, in-game. Plus, we've already got Iron Head, so now I'm gonna hold off on Bullet Punch. It's a great move competitively, though. Alright, she's got a Shroomish. Let's just keep going for Echoed Voice. It should one-shot everything now. I don't know. Am I gonna regret not getting Bullet Punch? I don't know. Iron Head's better, power-wise. Alright, she's got a Goldeen. And this thing's about to get one-shot. Or one-shotted. Getting some nice experience for everybody, though. Not bad. Not bad at all. Bob grew to level 26. Next Pokemon is a Budu. This thing evolves into Roselia, then Roserade. Roserade's such a badass Pokemon. That's such a cool name too, Roserade. I like it. I should use my Roserade more often competitively. Such a cool looking Pokemon. Alright, I think her last Pokemon is this Skitty. Wait, does she have 2 more? Yeah, she's got 2 more, my bad. So yeah, Echoed Voice is just destroying everything. I wonder what the base power is on it now that I've used it so much. It's probably in the hundreds. Twerkachu grew to level 26 and wants to learn Spark. Let's see if that's any better than Electro Ball. Electro Ball... the faster the user is, then the target, the greater the power. I think Spark has like a 60... Oh, 65. Oh, but it's a physical move. Let's keep Electro Ball. Because Pikachu's fairly fast. But then again, we... oh well, whatever. I was going to say we do have a minus speed nature, which kind of sucks, but... We'll get better electric moves later on. Her next Pokemon is an Azurill. This is her last Pokemon. So obviously this thing's going to die to an Echoed Voice. Now that we've used it, what, 7 times now? Alright, let's switch out Gertrude. Let me see, is anybody else gonna evolve soon? Pikachu evolves with a Thunderstone, which we don't have. Everybody else is evolved. The only 2 Pokemon on our team now that need to evolve still are Matang and Bob. Bob evolves at level 36. Matang, I want to say, evolves at level 40 or 45. So they both have kind of a ways to go. I'm going to switch in Rudy. Actually, well, I guess it doesn't matter. They're both level 25. It's whatever. All right, here's a bug catcher guy. Oh man, this guy looks evil. Do you see his face? He looks fucking evil. Alright, he's got a Nincada. Alright, so Nincada is part ground type, so we can't kill it with Thunder Fang. So let's go for a Howl. I actually probably should have switched. It's probably going to Leech Life me. It's going to be super effective. Okay, never mind. He just goes for Harden. Alright, so he's getting erect on us. So let's go for Bite. And our Quick Claw activates, not that it matters. And that is a dead Nincada. Alright, Rudy's level 26. And when is Gertrude gonna level up? Alright, let's switch out into Gertrude. It's the only one that's still level 25. Bringing out the Dustox. Alright, let's go for Air Cutter. Super effective. I love how Pelipper looked angry when it used Air Cutter. Its eyes just look angry. It's pretty cool. Next Pokemon is Beautifly. Alright, look at Pelipper's eyes when I use Air Cutter. It looks mean. It looks mad. And that is a dead Beautifly. Alright, Gertrude's level 26. Everybody's level 26 now, which is great. Let's see, I think the next gym leader is gonna be Flannery, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, Flannery is the next gym leader, then our dad, then Winona, Liza and Tate, and then for the Triforce badge, it's gym leader Wallace. But we're probably not gonna get to Flannery today, or at least not in this video. Alright, there's an item down here. It's a great ball, nice. Nice and free stuff. Alright, let's sneak so we- oh, well, never mind. I was gonna say, let's sneak so we don't run into a Pokemon, but we ran into a Pokemon anyway. Oh, sweet! A Roselia! That actually is not bad. Ah, it's only level 14, though. I tell you what, I'll make a deal with you, Roselia. If you do not die to this Thunder Fang, because it's a resisted hit, I will catch you. Okay, it didn't die, so we're gonna catch this thing. And it has- oh my god, it has Poison Point. That little bastard. At least we got the flinch. Alright, let's hurl some balls at it. Let's throw our Premier Ball. I love the look of this thing. One, two, three, and caught it. Alright, be right back, guys. My dad's home and he's gonna talk to me. So let me get through this little thing. Do we want to nickname the Roselia? Let's name it Rosa. That's what my competitive one's called anyway. Oops. Alright guys, I will see you in a moment. Alright guys, I'm so sorry for that. Whenever my dad gets home, he likes to say hi. So, I was talking to my dad. But I'm back now, and I rewatched the portion of this video that I already recorded. And I noticed that the game audio was really low, so I turned that back up, so hopefully you guys can hear the game audio a little bit better. I'm sorry for that in the first part of this video, but as of right now, till the end of this video, the game audio should be fine. I don't know why I had that game audio cut down so far, but whatever. Alright, so let's continue on. There's a Pokemon breeder here. Hopefully she doesn't have six Pokemon like the last breeder that we just faced. As I said before, yep, see, she's got six Pokemon. Or he. As I said before, most Pokemon breeders, they have a lot of Pokemon on their team. Usually like 5 to 6. Alright, so we're gonna lead off with Rudy, and we're still poisoned, so let's go ahead and heal that real quick. Status restore. I believe it's Pecha Berries. Yep, Pecha Berries heal poison. So let's go ahead and get rid of our poison. Hopefully we don't get, like, poisoned again from this battle. Alright, Wishmer is going to go for the Howl. It's going to raise its own attack, which is a little scary, actually. Let's go for a Howl of our own to raise our attack, and hopefully we can one-shot this thing. I don't know, Wishmer are kind of bulky. They have a decent attack stat. Or HP stat, not attack, what am I saying? Alright, so Bite does in fact one-hit KO. So that's good. I don't really understand her reasoning for going for the Howl than going for a special type move, but okay. Next Pokemon's gonna be a Makuhita. And hopefully we can one-shot this thing. We're 9 levels ahead of this thing, so hopefully a Thunderfang will take it out. It's gonna go for the Fake Out and flinch me, but that's fine because we're gonna outspeed. And my Quick Claw activates, not that it matters. I swear, my Quick Claw only activates when it doesn't matter. So we do one-shot the Makuhita, which is nice. We are so far ahead of these guys level-wise. Alright, his next Pokemon is a Zigzagoon. I'm sorry, all Pokemon breeders look like girls to me. Alright, let's go for a Bite. And that is a dead Zigzagoon. That plus one attack boost really comes in handy. Next Pokemon's gonna be an Aran. And this thing probably has Sturdy, which is a little bit annoying, but we'll make it do. Alright, let's bite this thing. And it... Oh, wow, okay. So it's too bulky for me. One more bite should do the trick. It's gonna lower my speed. That's fine. We do have a Quick Claw. Hopefully it'll come in clutch sometime. That's a dead Aran. Let's see, she's probably got... Or he. I keep saying she, god. She's probably got like 2 Pokemon left. Next Pokemon is a Talo. Yeah, he's got 2 Pokemon left. Oh, I should have gone for Thunderfang. Oh well, Bite's probably gonna kill anyway. I'm at plus 1, so... That's a dead Talo. And his last Pokemon is going to be... a Poochyena. Cool stuff. Alright, let's just go for a Thunderfang. Switch things up. And that's a dead Poochyena. Alright, Metangrew to level 27. So that's cool. Alright, let's see here. Everybody's level 26 except Metang, so let me switch you all the way to the bottom. Alright, there's a trainer here. There's that noise again. It's gotta be a wild Pokemon in the grass. Alright, she said that she planted all these flowers. I wonder if there's a hidden item anywhere. Oh, there's a Megastone right here. Mawile Light, awesome. So we just found our second Megastone, that's cool. Oop. Alright, let's see, there's a tree for us to cut. Let's see, is there any item worth getting over here? Okay, yeah, there's a Pokeball over there. Alright, so let's go ahead and cut this tree down. Aw, that's awesome, we got the Mawile Light. I wish I had a Mawile to use it on. Oh well. I really don't feel like going back to Dewford Cave and catching a Mawile, so it's whatever. Alright, let's go ahead and heal our guys since we are now in, I think, I don't even know how to say this place. This place's name. Verdanturf, I think. So we made it to Verdanturf Town. I guess that's how you say it. Alright, let's talk to some people, try to get some free stuff. It's what we always do when we make it to a new town. Alright, what is this guy? Let's see. Okay, he doesn't give us anything, so it's not important. Alright, this is kind of a small town anyway, so... Alright, there's the Pokemart. Let's see if anybody inside wants to give us anything for free. Alright, he's just talking about the X items. What about this girl? Alright, she's talking about Pokeballs. Alright, here's another contest haul. I really don't want to do another contest. Oops. But there's usually people inside. So let's just talk to them, but we're not doing another contest. At least not right now. Okay, she gave us the TM for Attract. Alright, let's see. Anybody else? Anybody want to give us anything cool? What about you, kid? Oops. What about you? Alright, nothing good there. Alright, I believe one of these houses is Wally's, or his grandparents. Let's see, who's this? Oh, okay. Let's check this house. She's talking about Evergrande City, which is where the Pokemon League is. Alright, what about this house? I think this is Wally's house. Yeah, okay, so this is his grandparents' house. He said he had to train more. We haven't seen him since. Okay, so Wally's out somewhere training. Alright. So I guess we should get rid of this boulder so that her daughter and her boyfriend or whatever can see each other. So let's do something nice for somebody. And we have Rock Smash, so... Oh, there's a trainer here. Hiker Mike. I didn't know Mike was in this video. Hi, Mike. Alright, he's got a Geodude. Alright, let's just bite this thing. It's probably got Sturdy. Oh, wow. So it actually didn't even bring it down to Sturdy. And its magnitude did like no damage to me. Sorry, Mike, but you kinda suck in this game. Alright, Rudy is level 27 now. Awesome sauce. Next Pokemon is a Machop. So let's switch into Gertrude. She loves eating Machops for breakfast. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Alright, let's go for an Air Cutter. And that's a one-hit KO. Goodbye, Machop. And does he have one more Pokemon? Nope. Alright, GG Mike, GG. It's payback for our Wi-Fi battle. Alright, I believe the rock that we have to break is this way. Oh, maybe not. Wait, what is this way? Just out of curiosity. I dropped my glasses. Can you help me find them? Sure, they're like right here. I just remember that from the old games. So it's the black glasses which power up dark type moves. Alright, so he's just gonna let us keep the black glasses. And we could actually put that on Rudy. But I kinda like the quick claw on him. Alright, let's use the item finder. There's an item here. It's an HP up. Cool stuff. But it doesn't look like there's any hidden items. There's a couple spots for secret bases though, that's cool. Alright, so that's not the rock we need to break, it's right here. Okay, there we go. I want to do something about this boulder, but it's beyond me to deal with it alone. Your Pokemon, it can use Rock Smash. Please, use Rock Smash and break up these boulders. Sure. Wow, you shattered those boulders blocking the way. To show you how much I appreciate it, I want you to have this. Aggronite! Third Megastone. Awesome. Now the lovers are reunited. Reunited and it feels so good. That's why I don't sing anymore. Alright, we found a Max Ether, or Ether. I'm not sure how to say it. Ah, come on. Wow, seriously? We found a wild Pokemon when I was struggling like that to get out. Alright, it's a Whismur. I'm just gonna run. These things are low level. It's level 8. Yeah, it's not even worth my time. And actually, let's go ahead and switch party members up real quick. Since Rudy's level 27, let's go into Torkoal. Alright, let's talk to this girl. I think she said something about the boulder. Oh, okay, never mind. Let's see, that's Wally's house. What about... Let's see, what do you want? Your Shroomish got lost, and it disappeared around the sign. Alright, so if you talk to the main town sign right here, her Shroomish, after you beat the game... Oh wait, no, never mind. I was gonna say, I thought you had to beat the game first, but I guess not. But if you talk to the sign, the Shroomish comes out from behind, and she gives you something cool. She gave us the Intriguing Stone, which, if we take it to Mr. Stone, it actually turns out to be a Pidgeotite. So it's another Megastone. Let's go have a look at it. So it's in the key items. So that's what the Pidgeotite looks like. We'll do that sometime. Alright, but I think that's everything in this town. Let's go ahead and heal up again. And let's head back to Maulville City, I guess. And on to Mount Chimney. This video is going to be really long and take forever to render, I'm sure. Alright, so let's just run back. And oh, you know what we never did? We never picked up our bike from Maulville City. So let's go ahead and pick up a bike. And there's two different bikes in this game. One of them is called the Mach Bike. One is called the Acro Bike. And the difference between the two, the Mach Bike is just used to move faster, and the Acro Bike is used to do like tricks and stuff. You can do like wheelies, and you can hop on like little things. I'll show you guys. Alright, so here's the bike shop. Alright, so let's talk to this guy. Hang on. Sorry about that, guys. My dad was talking to me again. Alright, so he said our shoes are awfully dirty. Yes, we came from Little Root Town. Alright, so he's gonna give us the option to choose which bike we want, the Mach Bike or the Acro Bike. I kinda want the Acro Bike, because I like doing all the little tricks and stuff. It's really cool. And you can always talk to him to switch bikes. Alright, so let's check out the... Oops, not save. Oops. Alright, Acro Bike, we're gonna register you. Alright, let's hop on our bike, and if you press B, you can actually do a wheelie, which is pretty cool. And you can also jump, which I think is pretty cool. But I'm gonna be right back, guys. My dad's bugging me again, so I will be right back. I'm so sorry. Alright, guys, I'm back now. I am so sorry, guys. I apologize. My dad just loves to interrupt me while I'm recording, but I'm back now, guys, and hopefully we won't have any more interruptions. So let's go ahead and head on to Mount Chimney, and we can conclude this episode. This has definitely been an eventful episode, to say the least. Uh-oh. Team Aqua Grunts. Where are we supposed to be? Where are we going again? It's Mount Chimney. Stay spaced out and you'll get scolded by Archie. Mount Chimney? It'll be a long walk going along Route 112 to get there. I wonder if I should buy lunch first. It's like nighttime. It's like dinner time. Go get you some dinner. Alright guys, we are finally back on Route 111. And popping some wheelies. Alright, let's go ahead and head on to, I guess Mount Chimney. Oh lord, here's another Pokemon breeder. Please don't have, like, six Pokemon. Okay, so it's not a trainer. Alright, so here is the Windstraight house. This is a family. It's like a family of four trainers, and you have to beat them all, and you get like a prize or something. All right, so let's challenge their family. Let's see how well we do against the Wind Straits. All right, so this guy has a Talo, and supposedly these guys get progressively harder. Alright, so this isn't really the greatest matchup for me, but I do carry the Rock Tomb, so I'm just going to do that. It's super effective. And that's a dead Talo. Alright, we leveled up to level 27, so it's time to switch out and let somebody else level up. Alright, he's going into Zigzagoon, so let's go ahead and switch out into Torkoichu. Alright, this Zigzagoon's probably not gonna fare well against this Icicle Crash, so let's go for that. Oh, that animation gets me every time. I love it so much. Alright, he's got a berry. I guess it's an orange berry. Yep, orange berry. Thank God it's not a citrus berry. That would almost put him at full health. Alright, let's just go for an Electro Ball. Should kill the Zigzagoon, and it does. Alright, so now we have to face the second member of the Wind Straight family, which I believe is going to be his wife, and then the grandma, and then the grandchild, I believe. Alright, so I believe this is going to be his wife. Alright, it is. Alright, she has a Roselia. Oh, I wish Bob knew Aerial Ace. Let's go... you know what? Let's switch. Let's go into Gertrude. Hopefully it doesn't poison me or whatever. Alright, she's gonna go for the Magical Leaf. Oh, that attack looks awesome. Alright, let's go for the Air Cutter. Alright, that's a one-hit KO. That Roselia's gone. And that was her only Pokemon, I believe. Gertrude grew to level 27. Cool stuff. Torkoichu grew to level 27. That's cool. Alright, I believe the... okay, no, it's the child, then the grandmother. Alright, this one has three Pokemon. She starts off with Goldeen, so that's not bad for us. I'm just gonna go straight for the Leaf Blade and hope for a crit. Oh, okay, I kill it without a crit. That works too. Next Pokemon's gonna be a Numel. So let's switch into Gertrude again. I believe Numel is a fire ground type, so our water attack should do a decent chunk, if not kill this thing. It's only level 16. Yeah, that should kill. We're like 10 levels higher. And your last Pokemon's gonna be a Shroomish, which we can stay in on, because we do pack the Air Cutter. So let's just go for that. And that's a dead Shroomish. Alright, I believe there's one more Wind Straight person. Yep, the grandma. And I think she has a Metatite, if I remember correctly. Wind Straight Vicky. Yep, she's got a Metatite. Once again, I wish I had the Aerial Ace on Bob. But it's all good. Let's go for a Mega Drain, see how much damage it'll do. Alright, it does about half. Not bad. All Alright, another Mega Drain should do the trick. And that's a dead Metatite. Alright, we easily defeated the Windstrait family. So I don't know if they give us something for beating them all. I would think they do. Gave us some nice money though. Not bad, I'll take it. Alright, let's go inside. I think they give us something. Alright, so he talked about their son. It's actually interesting to note that their son is actually in Victory Road later in the game. Alright, so they gave us the Macho Brace, which I believe powers up physical moves. So that's actually not bad. Oh, so right there was a hint. She said that her grandson, which is their kid, should be challenging the Pokemon League champion right now, so there's a little hint. It looks like they got some nice little trophies and awards and stuff there. That's cool. So they must be like some kind of a prestigious family or something. Alright, let's see. Is there any items for us to pick up? You know what? Let's ride our bike. We just got the thing. Alright, there's some rocks for us to break. Wild Pokemon came from the rock. What's it gonna be? Oh, that animation was sick. It's a Geodude. Eh. I don't really feel like catching a Geodude or anything. Let's just go for a Leaf Blade. Just because I like the animation so much. And of course it has Sturdy. It's gonna get Magnitude 9. Wow. I think its magnitude goes from like 1 to 10. And so 9 was like one of the more powerful ones, but it still didn't even do that much damage. Alright, that's a dead Geodude. Alright, let's check the party. Let's check levels real quick. Alright, 27, 27. Everybody's 27. Okay, I can keep Bob up front until he levels up. Alright, let's battle these two. It's gonna be a double battle, which is cool. I like double battles. So they have a Magnemite and a Wishmer. And then after the battle, they're gonna ask us for an interview. Alright, so we need to get rid of this Magneton. Or not Magneton, Magnemite. Because Gertrude does not want to take an electric type attack at all. So let's just double attack the Magnemite. Please kill. Thank you. Alright, he tried to confuse me, but he missed. So that's cool. Alright, let's go for a Mega Drain on the Wishmer. And a Water Pulse on the Wishmer. Or Wismer. Alright, that's a dead Wismer. And it looks like Bob is going to level up. Alright, Bob's level 28, so we'll have to switch him out. Wants to learn agility. That's not really useful because Bob's already fast as hell. Oops. Alright, there we go. Alright, I really don't want to do the TV interview thing just because it's a waste of time. No. Alright. Oops, I didn't mean to go in my bag. I meant to switch Bob out. So we'll switch you out for Rudy. Everybody's getting some nice levels before we take on Flannery. Alright, here's another Pokemon trainer. It's gonna be a Picnicker Irene. She has a Plusle. Hopefully this thing does not have static. If it does, I will be very sad. Let's go for a bite. I don't even know if it gets static now that I think about it. Alright, her next Pokemon is a Illumise, I believe is how you say it. Which is a bug type. And I don't have anything good for bugs. Let's just go for bite. Oh, wow. Okay. My Quick Claw activated, but it went first because it used Quick Attack. So my Quick Claw was useless there. Rudy grew to level 28, so I'm going to have to switch him out. Wants to learn Scary Face. It's not really useful. Matang also grew to level 28. You're disgustingly good. I thought I was the only one that says disgusting. Alright, Rudy, let's switch you out for Torkoichu. Alright, next trainer. I'm full of pep, he says. Camper Travis, and he has a Sandshrew. Alright, this isn't that bad for Torkoichu. We can Icicle Crash this guy. As long as we don't miss, and we don't. Should be a dead Sandshrew. Oh wow, it lives. Holy crap. Oh, that's so cool, its animation. How it gets into, it curls up to, into the little ball. That was really cool. I love how when Pikachu uses Quick Attack, it like turns around and walks back into position. That's really cool. Oh, another trainer. Backpacker Emery, and he has a Talo. So Pikachu's gonna eat this guy for breakfast. Alright, let's go for an Electro Ball. Alright, it's gonna Quick Attack me. But my Electro Ball should take it out. Talo's level 21, ooh. Their levels are starting to catch up now. Alright, I believe up this way is where the sandstorm is, and we can't go there because we don't have the Go Goggles. God damn it. Alright, sorry about that. Sorry for the language, my dad's bugging me again. It's really annoying when I'm trying to record. I've told him I was recording. I'm sorry, guys. Oh boy, here's May. What does May want? Alright, she said, look up there, there's Mount Chimney. It sure is big. That's what she said. Oh, sweet, she's gonna heal our Pokemon. Cool. Oh, and she's gonna give us something. Oh my god, she gave us the HM for Strength. Awesome sauce. Alright, so we can't use Strength until we get the fourth badge. So she's off to Fall Arbor Town. Alright, so let's go ahead and teach Strength to Linoone. That would be a perfect move for Linoone, because it gets Stab and everything. Alright, let's get rid of... Let's get rid of Tail Whip. Alright, here's another Pokemon trainer. It's another Picnicker. I won't cry if I lose. Alright, Camper Larry, and he has a Talo. Alright, let's just go for the Electro Ball. They were so kind to heal us. And a Zubat, who is going to die to this Electro-Ball. Alright guys, I think I'm going to actually end the episode once I get to Mount Chimney, and I'm just going to save Mount Chimney for the next episode, just because my dad's going ham on me tonight, so... I was planning on this being a kind of like a special long edition episode, but... I guess that's not gonna happen with him around. I try my best to record when nobody's home, just for situations like this. Alright, so this should be the last Pokemon trainer that I face in this episode. She has a Gulpin. Yeah, I'm sorry about that, guys. But the next episode should be up tomorrow anyway. I'm trying to upload daily, so... So far, I've been doing really well about uploading daily. You guys probably won't even see this episode until a week after it's recorded, so... So right now, I'm recording on November 25th. And it's probably not going to go up for quite a few days. Alright, Twerkachu grew to level 28. Alright guys, I think I better end the episode here. My dad's driving me fucking crazy. So, I'm just gonna end it right here on the steps. And in the next episode, we're gonna head on and check out Mount Chimney and see what those Team Aqua grunts are up to. If you enjoyed this episode, minus all my dad's interruptions, leave a like. It helps out the channel a lot. Follow me on Facebook and Twitter. Like, favorite, subscribe, comment. I'll see you guys in the next episode. Toodles.